And why only among the non-Muslims and the Westerners? Sheikh Sulaiman Abdul Aziz Al-Rajhi, may Allah preserve him and give him a long and a good life. He is the example of people. When he invited me once for dinner, I didn't recognize who's the host. Is this the guy who is in the Forbes list, one of the wealthiest people in the world? And he is introducing the food by himself, and he's serving, and he's such an old man, mashallah, an honorable person. And this guy donated literally all his wealth, fi sabilillah. He made it waqf. And anything that he invests in it, even in turab, in dirt, he will turn into tibr, into gold. Subhanallah. What was he before? Also around the age of 10, he was working as a carrier at the seaport, loading and unloading shipment. Very humble. For some, you know, loaf of bread to eat. He has become one of the earliest people in the world. How? From halal and also working hard. Islam encourages us to do that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says in the hadith, and please pay attention to this hadith, المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف. قوي يعني strong. Strength is not only in building muscles, spending all the time at the gym, but strength in knowledge, strength in health, strength in job, in position, in wealth. Why? Because you're not being beneficial only for yourself, but for others as well. He is better than the weak believer. Both are okay, but the stronger is better. Then he says, وَالْيَدُ الْعُلْيَا خَيْرٌ مِّنَ الْيَدِ السُّفْلَى. The upper hand is better than the lower hand. What is the upper hand? Huh? The hand which gives. The hand which gives. Normally, the beggar's hand is low, is under the giver's hand. So the Prophet ﷺ says, the giver's hand, the upper hand is better before Allah than the beggar's hand.